So before we begin, you want to make sure that you have the calendar option installed so you can just go to help installed software. And under options, you should see WinCC Unified Calendar. You can see that I've got update 2 installed. And you also want to have WinCC Unified Performance Insight. We're going to be using this for the KPIs in the next section. So the first thing that we need to do is create a time model to show what a normal production day looks like. So we'll have times of production, times for breaks, time for scheduled maintenance, and also we'll have the ability to earmark times that were for unplanned downtime, which will help us improve that. So under your Plant Objects tab, expand the common data and you'll see time model and just right click on it and choose open. So the top level node is going to be your whole model. So we can call it something like total time. And then you can see that we can give it a color. So for this, I'll just go choose black. And then there's a checkbox for relevant for calendar. That's going to be important before we actually start creating our calendar. So we have to make sure to mark those for the appropriate nodes. So for our time, we're going to right click and choose add time category. And that's just going to be a category for what type of time during the production day this is. So let's call the first one scheduled production. And that's going to be the parts of the day where we are supposed to be producing. And then I'm going to add another one that is just called normal production. Now, if we have maintenance activities or other things where we shut down, then let's create another node that goes under the top level node. So you can see it's on the same level as scheduled production. And we'll just call this planned downtime. And then under that category, we will add maintenance. And then we'll add another one called scheduled stop. So maybe that's for a changeover or something like that. And then finally, we're going to add another node under our top level node. And this is going to be unplanned downtime. And I will right click there and we're going to add waiting for parts. And we'll also just have a regular downtime section. Now here under relevant for calendar, you can see that we can check kind of any of these. And we want to check the actual categories that we're going to use in planning our day. So it's going to be the bottom level node. So we're going to check normal production. We will check maintenance and scheduled stop. And we will also check waiting for parts and downtime. And when we go to create the templates for our calendar, you'll see why. We can also give these some kind of meaningful colors here. So for normal production, let's just give it a different color green there. And then for our maintenance, we'll choose gold. That's a good color. We'll choose orange for our scheduled stop. And then unplanned downtime is bad, so waiting for parts will kind of give it a warning color of yellow, and downtime will give it red. So that is our time model that we'll use, and I'll just click Save Project. So the next step is going to be adding a calendar to our line equipment. So you can see that we have our conveyor and then subnodes under that are motor and pump. So I'm going to put calendars on the conveyor, which will also include our motor and our pump. So to add a calendar, we'll just right click on the node and choose open. And then we'll go to our calendar node and you see everything's grayed out. You have to go up and add a calendar to the equipment. So I'll just click add calendar. And here we're going to define some of the top level properties like how long is a shift, what is the first day of the work week, things like that. Beginning of day offset. The beginning of the day is midnight, so let's say that our shift starts at 9 a.m., so let's just do a 9-hour offset. and we run during the weekdays. And then the interface variables, these are going to be variables that we can use to determine the state of production. And you can see the interface variables for the sub equipment, motor and pumper there. So I am just going to choose value and state for each piece of equipment. And then we will hit save. I'm going to do the same thing on my line 2 conveyor, so I'll open the object, add a calendar, give it a 9-hour offset, and then choose my interface variables. And then I'll save this. Okay, so at this point, we need to compile and download this to our processor. So I'm just going to right click on this. I use the simulation to do this, so I can just start simulation, and it is going to compile and download this to PLC Sim. So I'll search for my equipment. It finds it, we'll select the one and just hit load. And since this is the first time that I've done this, I don't have a permanent certificate yet, so I'm just gonna consider it trusted. And then we'll just click load again. And now it's also asking me, do you want me to start the module? We'll say start module. I'll hit finish. And then you can see it is putting our simulated PLC into run. So now it's your turn. If you haven't done so before, go ahead and install the PI options for Shift Calendar and Performance Insight. You'll probably have to reboot after you do that, and then check your installed software to make sure you have the proper updates. Once you've done that, open your course project and open the Plant Objects tab, and under Common Data, create your time model and save it. Add a new calendar object to each conveyor plant object in your plant view. Assign your offset of 9 hours and select interface variables of value and state for each equipment. Finally, go ahead and compile and download to your PLC processor or PLC Sim. So go ahead and pause the video and complete these steps.